Bande Guru Pada Dandam Bhakta Binda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande Nitta Ananda Sahoditam Sri Nanda Nandanam Bande Radhika Charana Dayam Gopijana Samayuktam Bindavanam Manoharam Vāñcha kalpataru asya kipāsindu bhavecha Patitānaṁ pāvane bhavaiṣṇavebhyo namo namaha Mūkaṁ karoti vācālaṁ pangum langhaita giriṁ Yat kipātam ahaṁ bandhi paramānanda madhavam Vṛndāvai tulsidevvai piyāvai kesavasucha Krishna Bhakti Pade Devi Satya Vatvai Namo Namaha Narayana Namaskritta Naranchaiva Narottama Devin Swaraswating Vyasam Tato Jayo Mudirai Sankirtane Krishna Kato Padesh Gauriya Patrasya Prakasanecha Sadanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukta Bhakti Pramodaksha Jagod Varun Deyam Sada Paribhavagnam Abhishchaduham Tethas Padam Siva Virenchenutam Saranyam Bhitatiham Panatopal Bhavadiputam Bande Mahapurusate Charanaravindam Yat pada pallavana kachandamani chataya Vishpurjita kimapikabhavadu swadarsh Purnan ragara sasagara saramurti Saradhikamai kada kipam karush Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Ajanulambita bhujau kanakabhadato Sankirtanai kapitaro kamalayatakshu Vishambaro dijavaro yugadharmapalo Bande jagat priyakaro karunabhataro Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Namami Gange Tava Padu Pankajam Sura surair bandito dibbarupam Bhuktin cha muktin cha dadasinitam Bhavanurupena sada naranam Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushi tobam bhagam Narayano Priyamanango Madapaharam Varanasi Purapati Bhajavishanatham Vagi Sajasya Badane Lakshmi Rajasya Bhakshasi Yasyastide Sambhi Vam Nishingamaham Bhaji Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Gaurangaika Gatir Bhajasitamati Si Gauradhamo Sthiti Sat Sat Swaika Vitir Kushanga Virati Dusto Vethani Skriti Siru Paikarati Sanatananati Sijivate Jostuti Sishidhanta Saraswati Vijayate Gauri Yogoshti Pati Sishidhanta Saraswati Vijayate Gauri Yogoshti Pati Gauri Yogoshti Pati Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru told that Gauranga ki vastu, what a unique object Gauranga Mahaprabhu is. If you have your desire to feel this thing, if you want to know, then anyway you will have to first of all leave all asasanga. Gauranga ki vastu ta jante hole Sarvagre asasanga parityag kara prayojan. Gauranga ki vastu, what an unique object Gauranga Mahaprabhu is. To know this thing, to feel this thing, first of all you will have to cut all asasanga from your life. Knowingly or unknowingly, or jiva, purposely or without, you know, purpose, they are actually, anyhow they are doing asasanga. But how you can avoid asasanga totally, that I told many times, that it is only possible by the mercy of pure Guru Vaishnava. Only and only by the mercy of pure Guru Vaishnava it is possible. Asasanga can come in different form. I told you, impersonalism, mayavad can come in countless different form in your life. You have no power to detect it, to arrest it, to feel it. Even those who are madhyamadhikari, those who are up to madhyamadhikari, even they sometimes cannot feel the magic spell of impersonalism and mayavad. So fine form, so many times I told before. But our identity, you know, our Guru Varga speaking, Prabhupada many times used to speak this sloka. Karmavalambaka kechit, kechit gyanavalambaka bayam tu haridasanam krishnadasanam padatranavalambaka. It is our identity. We want to identify ourselves as the servant of pure, servant of the servant of the servant of the servant of Guru Vaishnava, pure Guru Vaishnava. Prabhupada speaking, only those who are Paramahansa Guru Vaishnava, they can detect, they can arrest anytime. Any kind of, you know, impersonalism, you know, indifferent from coming, only they can detect, they can arrest. Otherwise, it is not at all possible for common people to understand. Only we will have to cry unto the lotus feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, Guru Bharga. That is the way out. You can remember when Mahaprabhu went to South India first. While starting for South India, Mahaprabhu started speaking one sloka, which you don't understand. Why Mahaprabhu speaking that way? Rama Raghava, Rama Raghava, Rama Raghava Rakshamam. Krishna Kesava, Krishna Kesava, Krishna Kesava, Bhai Imam, Rama, Rama, Raghavara. Why Mahaprabhu speaking? Our Guru Varga, actually, Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, actually, Mahaprabhu wanted to show us the way, how to save yourself. You know, how to save yourself in each and every fraction of second, you will have to stay with Guru Vaishnava. Mentally, physically you cannot stay. Mentally, at least you have to stay all the time. And Mahaprabhu praying, because South India is full of Mayavad, different kind of, you know, they are having no idea still today. Still today they have no idea about pure devotional activities, nothing. They think maximum Lakshmi Narayan, you know, seva is maximum. It's authentic. Krishna seva is not authentic. Krishna is doing all rubbish. So Krishna seva is not, they cannot understand. They cannot understand, they cannot feel. That's why still today. So Mahaprabhu wanted to show that while you are going in that way, always you will have to pray to Supreme Lord so that you can get protection from Mayabad, Chalo Bhakti Vichar. Any kind of, you know, problem can happen in fine form, you know, Asasanga can come. For protection, Mahaprabhu is going to pray unto the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord. That is our teachings. But the only way open is that without Guru Kippa, without pure Guru Vaishnava Kippa, without, you know, Sadguru Kippa, there is no other way. There is no other way. Even one can, somebody can memorize all Shastra, but still the feeling, of that all Shastra he cannot get. Only it is, you know, by the mercy of Gurudev he cannot feel. Shastra Anubhav he can. So, Gauranga ki vastu, what an unique object Gauranga Mahaprabhu is. To realize this point, to understand this point, first of all, we will have to take resolution in your life to avoid asasanga. Anyway, we'll have to take resolution that somehow we cannot allow asasanga to come and contaminate our heart. The way open, I already told Prabhupada speaking, that the only way open is to go on singing the glories of Supreme Lord, Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan, actually, Guru Vaishnava, you know, glorification we'll have to do all the time. Harikatha Kirtan. Prabhupada speaking, continuous Harikatha Kirtan, continuous Guru Vaishnava Seva can give respite. Bhattaji, bonded soul, can get respite from this burning, you know, material life only by this procedure. Prabhupada speaking, continuous Harikatha Savan Kirtan, continuous Guru Vaishnava Seva can save bonded soul from Maya, from burning state. No other way open before us. Yesterday I was, you know, touching this point that Prabhupada speaking, what do you mean by Hari Bhajan? What do you mean by Hari Bhajan? There is so much, you know, explanation, so many, you know, different, from different angle we can explain. But Prabhupada giving answer that to get rid of history and allegory is called Hari Bhajan. You cannot understand. Within this word, all the explanation of Hari Bhajan you can get. For total explanation you can get. To get rid of history and allegory is called actual Hari Bhajan. To get rid of history and allegory is called actual Hari Bhajan. Within this word, all in fine from all, you know, total explanation of Hari Bhajan, it is there. Bonded soul, always in touch with history. History mean, what do you mean by history? You know, the flowing, you know, incident of human life is called history. Allegory mean, different kind of, you know, conception coming inside your heart, different kind of, you know, baseless which is a baseless idea, different kind of conception, idea, passion, you know, love of passion, love of different kind of, you know, thing coming. It's called allegory. It's no connection with Hari Bhajan. So Prabhupada in one word wanted to speak in front of intellectual society to get rid of history and allegory. Is called Hari Bhajan. They can go on thinking whole life, they cannot understand what Prabhupada wanted to speak. Actually, there is big problem. Because Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, we are going to accept Guru, we are going to do Harinam in Mala, we are going to do Tilak Mala, everything Tilak, you know, everything, Kantamala, everything. We are observing Ekadasi, everything, Janmashtami, everything here. But still there is no improvement in Bhajan. Why? The only reason, that is, we are so foolish, we cannot understand what is satsanga, what is asatsanga. That we cannot understand. We are busy with our false pratishtha, glamour, position. One day, one devotee from Pachkula, he was crying in front of me. Somehow he met me, he heard something about me, and he was showing so much attraction for me. And I was waiting to see his passion of, you know, devotion. Then after that, he is crying in front of me all the time. And speaking, Maharaj, give Diksha. I said, I'm not giving Diksha actually. You can hear Harikatha. He is hearing Harikatha, everything. He is feeling some change. But not actual change. How? Then I can, you know, he is asking me, Maharaj, where to take Diksha? You are not going there. Then I told you, see, you can search Sadguru here. Yeah? You can feel, you are hearing Harikatha. After hearing Harikatha, you can develop, you know, sensitivity. Then you will have to also, you know, then you will have to think what to do. Then he is going to, you know, select. And after that he meet me. I say, you already issue? Yes, I went to that sadhu. You know, I am not going to name actually. I meet that sadhu. And when I meet that sadhu, I was feeling that he is really sadhu. And then you took decision where to take the diksha. No. Actually, he was aged, more than 80 years. So I thought soon he is going to leave body. So I thought decision to take diksha from that guru. And okay. This way, I am waiting long time. I am watching. In a mood of Baddha Jiva. I am not going to pass any remark so quickly, you know. So this way, bonded soul, according to their previous sanskar, they are going to jump into Maya. I have nothing to do. So this way, actually, I can say actually, Shankar Bhagavan speaking in front of Parvati Devi, that Devi, Gurubo Bahobo Santi Shisho Vittapaharakaha Durulabahas Sadguru Devi Shisho Santapaharakaha. Hey Devi, there is countless such Guru, so-called Guru in this world. There is no shortage of Guru. There is shortage of Shisha. There is shortage of Shisha. Is shortage of Shisha. We cannot find Shisha. Guru so many. So you see, Devi, in front of Devi, Shankar Bhagavan speaking, Je Guru Bo, there is countless Guru. But they cannot be called Guru. They are not actually Guru. Guru Bo, Bahobo, Shanti, Shisho, Vittapaharaka. They are always searching how much property that disciple have. Always try to, you know, take money, position, everything, property, everything. Durulabha Sadguru Devi Shisho Santapaharaka. But Devi, such Guru, is almost rare, most rare, almost rare. Who can? Jaharo nikote gile paap dure jaye, emono dayalo prabhu keba kotha paye. North Dakota speaking so much kirtan, so many. Gangar parashi hai paschate pavon darshane pavitra karo eito mangun. But we are coming, approaching Guru Vishnu with passionate heart. We cannot understand. We are watching Gurudev is, you know, tall figure or not, or short figure, or, you know, how much name fame is there. According to that, we are going to pass our judgment. But actually, we cannot understand. We can never understand the mood of Guru Vishnu. You know, you can never. Yesterday I was speaking about Naraji Maharaj. Why Naraji Maharaj wanted to expedite, you know, the process so that Kongsho can be killed. You can pass this remark that Naraji Maharaj is merciless. No, Naraji Maharaj is full of mercy. Naraji Maharaj is full of mercy. Whole Shastra I can discuss from different points. We can see Jamal Arjun, this, that, all different. I can show Naraji Maharaj is most merciful. But still, Naraji Maharaj want to expedite the procedure. Kongsho is the, you know, Kongsho by no means, Ravan, Kangsa, by no means, any amount of judgment, Shastra Vichar, mercy cannot stand. So useless. Follow what I mean to say. You can apparently think, why Guru Vishnu speaking this way, they should not speak. Are Maharaj, there is no way out. There is no way out. They are so big impersonalists that they are not going to believe. Guru Vishnu, nothing. So where is the way out? Guru Vishnu cannot find any way so that they can do something good for them. They are not ready to accept. So Balaji Maharaj trying his best, but after that Balaji Maharaj can kill them. You know, Balaji Maharaj is the final decision. Even Balaji Maharaj can try to protect Duryodhan, but ultimately not possible. They are not going to obey. In that case, they can, so long as they are staying in this material world, they can contaminate the whole devotional system, devotional line. So better if they die. You know, in Bhagavatam it is written, oh, poisonous snack. You know, it is written, those who are sadhu, they also become happy. When Ben Raja was finished, then sadhu, those who are Rishi Muni, they were very happy. Those who are sadhu, they also become happy. When Ben going to die, then those Rishi Muni, they become back, because he is going to disturb the whole system. They are going to disturb the whole, especially Prabhupada told, so long as this impersonal Mayavad, so long as a Mayavad is going to stay here in this, you know, devotional field, somehow it is impossible to install pure devotional, you know, practice. Impossible. Especially as present, in different form, Mayavadis, they are coming inside, you know, devotional society. And they are taking sannyas, brahmachari, they are going to take a big post. This way they are going to contaminate the whole system actually. So, it's big problem. So, Guru Vaishnava never curse. Guru Vaishnava never going to curse anybody. But automatically, what to do? They are interested about pure devotional field. At the time of Advaita Gosai, when Advaita Gosai crying, where to go? Whole situation, material situation all around, nobody going to hear and speak about Supreme Lord. The then situation, when Advaita Gosai was there singing the glories of, you know, Supreme Lord through Gita, Bhagavad, in Navadip, Mayapur. But who is going to hear? Some devotees, they get together with, you know, they're going to participate. And actually, Advaita Gosa had discussion and feeling sorry, where to go. All material was in a full of, you know, demons, where to go, you know. And also as per, you know, it's where to go. Where to go? Because devotees, they like to get, you know, association, pure association. But where you can get billions of dollars, you can get total, you know, you can get the kingship of total, you know, 13 world, 14 world. But still, satsang is so rare, so rare, so rare, that I cannot explain. Someday, if you can develop that kind of sensitivity, then you can feel that why I am speaking that way. Satsanga is so rare, that I cannot explain. But somehow, if you are going to get satsanga, still Mayadevi can deprive you if you are not sincere. You are getting satsanga, but still you can lose the opportunity. Upper Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Still, because nobody like to discuss the exact procedure of devotion. What is the pure devotional practice? Nobody interested. If you speak, they become angry with you. They think you are enemy. Pure devotional practice at present so rare, so rare. Why? Because nobody want to discuss. Nobody like to discuss. You know, it's big problem. Because if they discuss, and there is big problem. They cannot run their business, spiritual business. If they are going to discuss all this saying, and also you will have to take shelter of a pure Guru Vaishnava, without which this kind of discussion cannot stand in your heart. Without which, if you can hear Harikatha in different place, but it cannot stand. When you are going to hear Harikatha from Acharan Sil Vaishnava, a very perfect Acharan, very powerful Vaishnava, then that Harikatha can come and hit your heart like a bullet. Can give you a nice reaction inside your heart. Yesterday I was speaking, the Prabhupada explaining, Diksha Kale Shishka Kare Atmasam, this slok I was speaking, I have no time to explain this thing, but the only thing I like to speak, the Prabhupada speaking, Diksha, this procedure mean, if you are inclined, there is no duplicity, then 100% Sadguru can give you direct feeling inside your heart. Feeling of seva. You can feel some transcendental bliss inside your heart. Oh, and you can, you know, you can express your desire to serve. And gradually on doing Guru Vishnu seva and Bhagavad seva, you know, Tate Guru Sheve Kare Krishna Tate Guru Bhaye Kare Krishna Sevan Mayajal Chutipaye Krishna Charan. So this way, this is the procedure through which the Bhardajib can go out. They can, how you can know that this is pure Harikatha, this is pure Guru Vishnu, how you can know? What is the criteria, how you can understand? The only thing, after hearing, you can feel some reaction inside your heart. You can feel inspiration to see that Vaishnava, to take association of that Vaishnava, to serve him. You can get continuous inspiration to do something. Not that, you know, we are leading our life, you know, we are sitting and doing next to nothing, wasting our time. Whole our program, what you are doing, everything should be related with Guru Vaishnava Bhagavad Seva. That is the only way. There is a caution there in, say, Mahabharata. There is one caution, you see, there is What is that? That, you know, if there is no leadership, overall discussion I'm speaking, not only about spiritual, this point I'm discussing, overall discussion. You know, nashanti anayaka, nashanti bahunayaka, nashanti kunayaka, taranti, you know, sunayaka. Nashanti kunayaka, nashanti anayaka, nashanti bahunayaka, taranti sunayaka. I mean, there is no way out. If you find there is one, you are getting leadership of a man who is very ugly man, very cruel, kunayaka, like Benraj, Benraji Maharaj. You know, yes. This way in spiritual field also you can apply this formula. I am not going to explain. So nashanti kunayaka, you know, nashanti kunayaka. Kunayaka means if you are going to get bad leadership, spiritual leadership or political leadership, anyhow, you will have to apply according to the time and circumstances. Nashanti kunayaka, nashanti anayaka. If there is no leadership, all they are running fanciful, it is also dangerous. Nashanti kunayaka, nashanti anayaka. And yesterday I was joking, I was speaking, Maharaj, nashanti bahunayaka. Amra sabai raja amaderi raja rajate. We are all king. We are all king in our kingdom. So it's very nice. There is a situation at present. So this way the whole world going to jump into Maya. Not jump, they are already in fire. They are burning actually. You know. So taranti sunaya kaha. If we can get us leader like, you know, Parikshit Maharaj, Yudhishthir Maharaj, Ambarish Maharaj, Prithu Maharaj, Prahlad Maharaj, Dhruva Maharaj, you know, then we can save our life. Then we can save our life. Very good. Taranti sunaya kaha. Who has a devotional practice in his life, who love Krishna, Supreme Lord, ultimately not nastic. Impersonalism is nastic. I can take the asana of Acharya. Who can stop me? I can start giving diksha. You know, and make, you know, and, you know, this way. But this way, actually, total situation of devotional has contaminated. There is no yardstick. There is no standard. No yardstick. No standard. We'll have to standard. I told you many times, anything you, if you are going to pass any judgment, it is the teachings of Mahaprabhu. Amashabar baddhujibir hai shastok Sastodhara Gyan. And Krishna speaking. Tasmat sastho pramanante karja karjo vyavasthito. What is good, what is not good, what to do, what not to do. Are Maharaj, you can take decision according to the Siddhanta of Shastra. But who is going to speak Shastra? Misguide you. So, wrong preaching, your preaching is one kind of jibhingsa. I told you. I can substantiate. I can prove it like mathematics. Your preaching is one kind of jibhingsa. You are going to misguide people. You are going to misguide people. You know, yes, sir. At all, if they are not going to get any guidance, they're still okay. But if he is going to get misguidance, then, you know, from neutral position, he is going negative way. Negative way he is going. He is not positive way. Then, how he can come back or she can come back? She is already running negative way. And after that, if somehow luck is very good, then you have to buy somehow. You have to come to neutral point. First of all, you have to neutral point. From there, you have to proceed towards positive direction, which is devotional direction. All negative things we are accepting as devotion. If I explain, then you can go mad. All negative thing we are all going to accept as devotion. It's all negative. That's why you are not getting any result. Why you are not getting any result? That is the only reason for why we are not getting any result. So this way, you know, we cannot understand what is asasanga, what is satsanga. It's very dangerous situation. Just like underground world, you know. Those who are, you know, mafia from underground world, some countries, they are going to give them patronage. Yeah, you come. We can give shelter. This is the situation in devotional life. If I am going to take a strong step against some devotee whom I wanted to protect, then all other, they are going to, hey, you go this way, you speak, you fight with Maharaj. Then how I can give treatment to him? They are going to misguide. Many times my luck is so bad, I don't know. You know, maybe in horoscope it is written. What to do? Why I wanted to protect myself, I wanted to protect genuinely. From heart I am sitting in Vyasasana. I never wanted to cheat them. But my luck is this, you know. It's very good. This way I am, you know, growing detachment more and more. I have no detachment, I have attraction for material life. Maybe. Many times it happens so. I collect from garbage. I wanted to, they don't know even walk, okay, ABCD, nothing. I teach them, they said, they started business. You know. This way. I arrange dikha, their diksha, you know, jagya, everything I done. Oh, what not? Red clothes, everything. After that, they like to cut my throat. This is my luck. One devotee is a disciple of very famous Maharaj, I don't like to name. And whenever I meet him, I say, Prabhu, you try to stay with me. He's smiling, not giving any answer. Many times, Prabhu, you stay with me. You can at least do some kirtan nicely, I know, but his character is not good. So many complain there. Still, apparently his mood is very soft. Apparently. He's very aggressive, but apparently his mood is soft. So, I requested him, Prabhu, you sit. Ultimately, somehow he was bound to stay with me, and I allow him the opportunity to do kirtan with me. He can play mridanga, everything. Oh my God. Ultimately, he liked to cut my throat. So this is my luck. This is my luck. So it's very good. It's the arrangement of Nityananda. Nityananda giving me, you know, lesson. You know, this way. I'm very alert at present. Very careful at time. All the time. This way actually, you know, like terrorists. Those terrorists, they are invited by some country. You come, stay in, we can give you facility. This is a situation. When it was out of control totally, for the past 10 years, still I was not taking any decision. I'm thinking what to do. How to save that, you know, guy? He's going to do business. But he thought I am very weak. He thought I am very weak. That's why I cannot take. Ultimately, I am praying to Nrisimhadev Prabhu, what to do? I cannot throw him out. You know, but at the same time, I cannot accept what to do. Ultimately, I touch my pen unto the lotus feet of Nrisimhadev and started writing one note in library. Immediately, within 10 lines. If you understand Bengali, you can go mad. By the mercy of Nrisimha. Immediately within 24 hours, I print one pamphlet. And Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj's, one tithi was there, Samadhi Mandir Pratishtha. Immediately I send one to you, go and circulate this paper so that at least people can know. If he is doing all rubbish, then it's big problem. At least people should know that he is not no more with me. This much. I am not writing any rubbish, nothing. So sober, so nicely represented. But still, when some devotee wanted to distribute this paper, then one big leader, who is Dambushan, idiot number one, who is Dambushan, he wanted to speak. I was not there, but from here I know who told it. He told it, Prabhu, two Vaishnav going to fight, why you are going to and take pardon? Ay, Bab re Bab, so idiot. Very sweetly, then they stop distributing that paper. But I give in internet everything so that now if anything happen, at least nobody can take legal action against me. This much, I am free now. Whatever he is doing, all wrong activities, aparad, you know, all babichar, then I am not going to take share of his activities. This much I wanted to do. This is the situation about devotional line. And now, when Santo Goswami Maharaj was crying because one devotee is taking away land and property, everything, Santo Goswami ultimately declared, if somebody going to give, you know, give him, you know, protection in any mode, I have no connection with him. But what to do? One spiritual boss, he was, you know, so merciful, he gave him permission. You can stay here. Of course, he is also going to avoid Santo Goswami Maharaj because they have no right to come in front of Santo Goswami Maharaj. So we cannot pass this kind of him. At the same time, they are speaking, those who are distributing this paper, I was so angry. It was the not material angriness. You know, they are speaking with Shiksha Guru. At the same time, they are speaking like Mayavadi. Like Mayavadi speaking. You know? How I can say that Santo Goswami Maharaj is one Vaishnava and that, you know, that Dambushan, he is also one Vaishnava. Two Vaishnava fighting, why should I take part? If I speak this way, infinity period, I would be given punishment by Supreme Lord as an impersonalist. No devotional touch in this world, nothing. You cannot arrest, you know, they are so clever. All contamination, all there, you know. So pure devotees, they don't like to live anymore. What they can do? Only fighting. Day by day, new news can come. This happened, Maharaj there. This happened, Maharaj there. They are disinterested about that. You know. Why Jadavacharya wanted to kill Ramanujacharya? Can you speak? What is wrong with Ramanujacharya? Why Jadavacharya wanted to kill Ramanujacharya? Why? The only reason. If Ramanujacharya going to speak Harikatha, then very shortly people can discover that I am useless, but I am acting as Guru. I am acting as Guru. There is a situation. I am acting as Guru. They people, somebody going to prove how I can. I am spiritual mafia, no? I can kill, I can engage. Are Maharaj, you need not pay 10,000 rupees to a gunda, hooligan. Pure Guru is now automatically going away. They cannot stay. Like Bidurji Maharaj. Why you are going to waste 10,000 rupees you are paying to hooligan? Eh? Wasting your time? You keep it. You can spend this money in your, you know, personal benefit, AC, DC. Plane, you can use it. Why you are going to waste money? Eh? You need not waste money. You are very... This way actually, like Bidurji Maharaj. Maharaj Duryodhan is so puffed up, he can, is blind, he cannot see. He cannot see who is pure Vaishnava. He want to insult Bidurji Maharaj, Dasi Putra. You know, we are helping him to live. Is going against us, throw him out. You know, this way going to insult. You know, this way, don't know. They don't know what is the far-reaching consequent. They don't know what is the far-reaching consequent of this Vaishnava aparad. Infinity priority will have to take shelter in hell. So foolish, they are playing with Guru Vaishnava. They are playing with Guru's soul. Dhanamade, Vidyamade, Vaishnavna Chine. So popped up. Previously, they couldn't arrange two braids morning and night. Now they forget. They are belonging to such a poor family. Now they are, you know, declaring, well, I am a rich family. So poor. Even two time, one bread, two bread, they cannot arrange from that kind of family. Now, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, they are climbing Mount Everest. It is not mercy actually, it is curse. Guru Vaishnava can cheat you any time. Any time Guru Vaishnava can cheat you according to your cheating propensity, like a cheating mood. Common people, they think it is kripa. Prabhupada speaking, why not you see the results? Why not you see the fruits of the tree? Foolish number one. Phalena phalakaranam anumiyate. Phalena phalakaranam anumiyate. Why not you see the result, fruits of the tree? Then you can understand he is enjoying full guru kripa or he is going to enjoy full maya kripa. Then you can understand. Duryodhan want to insult Vidurji Maharaj and throw him out. Are Maharaj, Vidurji Maharaj is great, Vidurji Maharaj, Mahabhagavat. You want to insult him. You see the result. They say all, I am not cursing. Those who are all going. Those who are even those who are staying inside Gauriya Math. Those who are externally staying inside Gauriya Math. They are impersonalists. They are doing all activities against Gauriya Math. You know, they will be given heavy punishment they can get. Surely, it is not my curse. Automatically, it's an automatic factor. Those who are going against Gauriya, those who are staying, identifying himself, I am from Gauriya Math, but cannot prove he is from Gauriya Math. According to the discussion of Prabhupada, what kind of standard? What kind of scale you have? What kind of scale you have? So that you can measure a Guru Vaishnava? Foolish number one. What kind of scale you have? So that you can measure a Vaishnava? By looking his appearance? By watching his pratishtha? Material pratishtha and money? Only the standard is that. Sarup Gosai. Only the standard is that Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Only the standard is that Prabhupada. We'll have to watch everything. We'll have to. Sarup Gosai giving a standard of a Gaudiya devotee. If somehow you are not going to tally, you have to go away from that place. To save, you are going to into hell. Those who are following the track of Maya, also they are followers, they are also going. Jo bhakti nairahitam, jo bhakti nairahitam, annayena srinatiya. Both of them, both group, those who are going to speak wrongly, are going to hear from that source. Jo bhakti nairahitam, annayena srinatiya, to uho, brajateho. Brajataho nirayam kalamakshayam. And Pitama Vishwa speaking, you know, what kind of guru you are going to get? Who is not having any idea about what to do or not to do? It's simple, common sense. What to speak about moral character and nothing. What to speak about devotional, power. Pitama Vishwa is saying they have no idea. You know, what to do, what not to do. Karja karja majanato utpata patipanyasya. Utpata patipanyasya parityago vidyate. You will add to whole world. If they at all Gauriya society, if they are going to identify, and not actually for I am not speaking about them. Why I am bound, I was out of my strong grief, I am bound to speak that way. Why I am speaking that way? Not that I don't like to allow anybody to come in front of you. What I can do? If useless people coming and, you know, because quality and quantity cannot persist together. Don't, never mind when I'm speaking. That is my success, that people not coming to me. That's mean, those who can feel, they can surely they can come. I can allow them to come, but I cannot allow all foolish people, or useless. Never, no chance of doing any bhajan. They are simply going to contaminate. I don't cannot allow them. So the standard will have to all over the world. If you are going to identify yourself as an actual disciple of Gauri Amat, I give you one important, you know, seva on behalf of Prabhupada. Also, I am following. That is, you will have to, you know, set one yardstick standard, one scale, set by Sarup Gosai and Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur. And you will have to understand which is false, which is genuine, which is false. You have to think over and again. If you are 100%, if you are going to get absorbed in the Guru Vaishnava Seva, then nobody can cheat you. I can give you a guarantee. People going to cheat you because you are sometimes you are doing something, but other time you are, you know, not doing. Continuous Guru Vaishnava Seva, continuous Harikatha Kirtan can give very shortly. I promise you, I am sitting in Vyasasana. You know, why I told yesterday that way, I am going to take dust particle from their lotus feet, those who have their capacity to see, hear that kind of Harikatha. I must pay dandavat to them. But I cannot expect. I cannot expect thousands of people to hear this kind of katha. Very selected. They cannot digest. They cannot digest it. It's very dangerous. They cannot digest. Impossible. So, lacks of viewer doesn't mean it is Harikatha. Lacks of viewers, that doesn't mean it is Harikatha. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking Harikatha in front of two devotees, Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj and Gaurkisar Babaji Maharaj. That doesn't mean it is not Harikatha. You know, one pros going to dance without cloth. So lakhs of people mean crores of people can watch that dancing, very nice dancing, without any cloth. Because today our civilization, very nice civilization we have. So this is our civilization. And, you know, how we can get back the old situation? How we can get back that kind of, you know, golden, you know, situation? Not possible. Only possible if each and every, those who are going to identify themselves as Gaudiya devotee. And first of all, they'll have to sit for exam. You know, they have to sit for exam. Who is going to take test? Swarup Gosai, Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. If they declare you are, you know, okay, then you can act as Acharya. Not before that. Not before that. You know, all garbage gathering, you know, all garbage gathering, you know, only flattering personality can never become a preaching person. A flattering personality can never become a preaching personality. You know, this way. So standard set by Mahaprabhu, standard set by Sarup Gosai, standard set by Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Why you are going to change the standard? You want to prove you are more merciful? Eh? Why you want to change? You know? So why Jadavacharya wanted to kill Ramanujacharya? What was the mistake done by? The only reason that Ramanujacharya was speaking about the absolute truth. Ramanujacharya wanted to point out that it is Mayavad Siddhanta. It is Mayavad, it is not devotion. It is not devotion. You are staying in Gauri Amat, but Prabhupada speaking, even one night to stay in Gauri Amat in one night if it's impossible. To stay in Gauri Amat means to stay with all Siddhanta Vichara of Gauri Amat. Sridhar Goswami Maharaj used to say, Dushto Guru Theke Shunno Gwal Valo. And if the cow is very dangerous, not going to obey any rules, you know, very dangerous, then it is good that there is no, in Gaushala, there is no cow, but then, you know, a wicked Gaumata can, you know, make all problem. Now they are speaking like Mayabad. If we are going to pass judgment this way, we cannot get it. Are, who told you to open Gauriamat? Who told you to open new Gauriamat? You have seen Gauriamat, that you are going to inaugurate a new Gauriamat? Eh? Why not you try to glorify the name, fame and glories of Prabhupada and, you know, Chaitanya Mat? Why not? This is our tax seva given by Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. You know? Prabhupada wanted to install Gauriamat inside the heart of each and everybody. It is a dream. Now it is a dream. Prabhupada wanted to install Gauriamat inside the heart of each and everybody. That's mean that what I was speaking, you know, I was just speaking to set standard. All over the world, those who deserve, they are Gauriya devotee, Gauriamat devotee. It is their duty to understand the standard set by Sarva Gosai. Standard set by Jiva Gosai Bhat, Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda. Otherwise, anytime, they can go and jump into Maya. Nobody can protect. Even if you have taken shelter unto a lotus feet of Siddhar Gosai Maharaj, Bhaktivinoda, who is going to save? And how you can save yourself, because you are not going to follow Gurudev in total. Also there is, you know, so many problems. Because bonded soul, when Gurudev, so many devotees putting question, Maharaj. Now Gurudev was there, that time we couldn't understand. After that Gurudev gone, I have done aparad, how to get out of aparad? He's giving suggestion, this way you can do. Those who are nice devotees, those who are pure devotees, they can feel that Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Gurudev, always, Guru Varga, always with them. Pure Guru Vaishnava can feel each and every time that Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur or Guru Varga is there with him. But it is not possible for a bonded soul to feel that Guru Varg is there with him. Even if Gurudev gone, some material idea. Gurudev die, how to live? Are where Gurudev die? You have taken Diksha, you have no idea about Guru Tattva. And who has given Diksha? Also he has no direct realization about Guru Tattva. Otherwise, why is he speaking all rubbish in front of me? All rubbish. If you have no idea, no, you know, direct realization about Guru Tattva, how you can give Guru Tattva to somebody? Whereas it is the condition said by Krishna. Tat vidhi pani bhatena paribeshena sevaya upadekshantite jnanam jnanina stattva darshina. Somehow you will have to take shelter of a tattva jnani sadhu purush. Guru Tattva is a khanda tattva. So bonded soul, they are thinking Gurudev gone. Then they are displaced. They have no idea. So Baba speaking, bonded soul can never get inspiration to do Hari Bhajan. Bonded soul can never get inspiration to Hari Bhajan until and unless they are going to see a vivid example, a lightning example in front of them. Because they have no realization about direct dham, naam, nothing. A very preliminary stage. Very preliminary stage. If they are not going to see one enlightening example, you know, glowing example in front of them. Adarsha, a bonded soul, if not going to see any adarsha in front of them, they cannot get inspiration to do bhajan. Gurudev gone. So you will have to take shelter of a Sadguru, Shikha Guru, so that you can get proper, you know, guidance. This is the procedure. So, Jadava Acharya wanted to kill Ramanujacharya only for the reason that Jadava Acharya wanted to kill Ramanujacharya only for the reason because Ramanujacharya wanted to speak about pure devotion. And Jadava Acharya is Mayavadi speaking all rubbish which is not devotion at all. Why Krimikanta wanted to eradicate the eyes of, Kuresh? Because Krimikanta on behalf of Ramanujacharya with the dress, in the uniform of Acharya, in the uniform of Acharya Ramanuja, he went there to identify. And Krimikanta somehow wanted to change the mood of him. Hey, you have to be Shaiva, somehow. Haridas Thakur speaking, if my body life is going, if you are going to cut my body into pieces, still I cannot leave Harinam. Haridas Thakur, this is a resolution. But our division, we are going to think about favorable situation. Prabhupada used to speak, Jokhon Jedike Hawa Boy. In Bengali, Prabhupada, when I'm speaking one story, political situation, and now, yesterday I was with this political party, today I think this is favorable, I change and I am now in this party. This is the situation. Prabhupada used to speak, Jokhon Jedike Hawa Boy. Some people are there in the guise of devotees, they are watching which way the wind is blowing. They are going to change their mood and going to take part. That is why Mahaprabhu has given punishment to Mukundo. I cannot give kripa to Mukundo because he is changing his mood. He is going there, okay, nice. Samannayavad, reconciliation. In the way of pure devotion, no question of reconciliation. Nobody can speak that way. So, Kuresh was not ready, but then Krimikanta took decision to eradicate his two eyeballs. So what? Deho jodi jai, ana they are going to cut me into pieces, still my tongue cannot stop speaking Hare Kirtan, Hare Krishna Mahamantra. That is the mood of pure devotee. Narottama Thakur crying. Narottama Thakur crying heavily and speaking. Keno ba achoye pran kishu ko lagiya. Narottama Thakur crying and speaking. Oh my life! Why you are, still here in this body? Why not going away? Narottama Thakur crying heavily. Keno ba achoye pran kishu ko lagya? With what, judgment? What mood of enjoyment you are going to stay here, your life? Why you are not going to leave? This is a situation, negative situation all around. Ramchandra, Kaviraj gone, all Srinivas all gone. Why you, Prabhu, arrange me staying here? I like to also take leave from this material world. Narottama Thakur crying. Keno ba achoye pran kishu ko lagiya? This is the mood of Raganuga devotee. This is the mood of Raganuga devotee. They are crying and crying their night alone. Whom to apprise their painful heart? Who is going to hear? Nobody there. Mahaprabhu wanted to show us this mood of Raganuga Bhakta. Mahaprabhu wanted to show, Mahaprabhu speaking, Na prema ganda asti darapi me harau. I have no trace of love, no smell of love. I have no smell of love unto the lotus feet of Krishna, the Supreme Lord. Na prema gandha asti darapi me harau tathapi krandami shaubhagyavaram prakashatum jad vanshi vilasana na lokanam vina bibharmi prana patanga kana vritha, useless. Useless, why I am going to leave this insect, my life, still today living with what hope? With what positive hope? With what positive hope I am going to leave? Kenova chwe pran kishu ko lagiya. Mahaprabhu wanted to teach us, but what we are teaching? Mahaprabhu wanted to teach us, but what we are teaching? From whom? What we are teaching? Every fraction of second we will have to think over and again that I am approaching right direction or negative direction. In countless different form, impersonalism can come in your life to contaminate your total bhajan life. And little compromise, you know, a bit, if you are going to make compromise, then you can take leap from pure devotional practice. Pure devotion, Bhakti Devi, if you are somehow you are going to get deviated from the track of pure devotional track, then ultimately you are going to jump into mind. Nobody can try. You know. All people, they are speaking false philosophy. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba lecture. Are Maharaj, who is going to hear your lecture? We have no time to hear your lecture. We have no time to hear your lecture. If you have any feeling, you speak. That's why yesterday I told you, well, you all, you know, on world basis, we have to make one platform on which all genuine devotees they can stand, and they can try to eliminate all, you know, impersonalist activities, impersonalism. They should eliminate, and they should set one standard. It is all your duty. Those who are not knowing the standard of Gauriya Math, it is your duty to show this is the standard. You see, this is the standard. He is showing wrong. It's the standard. You have to follow this standard to get devotion, you know, bhakti. You know, this is what you have to do. You know, in different form, impersonalism can come to contaminate bhakti. So many incidents, what, you know, what to speak, you know. Popa speaking actually, some devotee going to some North Calcutta, some place, Dakshineshwar, to meet one so-called, you know, Mayavadi, and coming back. He's speaking this way, Prabhupada, this way. And in their book it is written, you know, yesterday I was just touching this. But now situation is that who can, you know, who can collect honey, who can collect honey, nectar, and give you nectar? Because you have no power to search nectar from, you know, Shastra. You have no power. How you can? I can give you lots of books. You have no direct ways. You can search and get puzzled. You know. So it is the duty of our honeybees to collect honey. It is not your duty, it is not my duty. It is the duty of Brahma. That's why in Sarvagoshtami's talk of Gita, it was written by Srinivasaji. Nana sastra vicharanaika nipuno sadharma samsthapako lokanam hitakarino tibubane manyo saranakaro. That's why it is nana sastra vicharanaika nipuno. There, you know, they wanted to get cream for you and me. Why you are going to take trouble? Very easy. All you will have to follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. Very easy. And those who are in line, like Sridhara Goswami, Mahakeshu, you can follow them. Very easy. In flower, there is sometime that, you know, honeybees coming, you know, From flower, we can get honey. From flower, we can get honey, sure. But do you know that in flower, poison is also there? You know, you heard, understand? In flower, honey is there. But do you know poison is also there in flower? So it is the duty of Brahma. Brahma means butterfly, honeybees, to collect honey. And lutakit, Prabhupada speaking, lutakit, one kind of dangerous, insect. They are also coming in flower, but it is their duty to collect poison from flower. Honeybee is going to collect honey from flower, and at the same time, some lutakit, one kind of special insect, going to collect poison from flower. It is the duty of lutakit to collect poison. So in Gauriya Math, so many things you can see. Brahma, butterfly, they can get honey, and somebody can take poison. On Navilas, nothing. This way they are taking poison. They are saying. This way, in different form. Impersonalism can come in our lives to contaminate our heart. You can remember I started with this sloka. Kechid karma valambaka kechid. Kechid gyana valambaka. Karma valambaka kechid. Kechid gyana valambaka. Bayam tu si haridasanam padatrana valambaka. This is our identity. Maharaj, you are practicing Bhagavad Dharma. And you are getting poison? Impossible. Impossible, Bhaktivinoda, impossible. You are taking shelter and you are getting poison. You cannot understand bhakti. You are going in a negative way. How possible? How possible? You have taken shelter, guru, you are doing ekadashi, these, everything you are doing, damparikra, everything, but you are not getting result. Why? The only reason you are doing asasanga. Still today, I think you don't understand what is Bhagavad Dharma. The day by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, you can understand little bit, if you can understand. You can get the taste of Bhagavad Dharma. Like Haridas, you are bound to speak. If you are going to cut my throat, still you are not going to change my Siddhanta Vichar. It's Bhagavad Dharma. Whereas it is written in Bhagavad, it is really surprising. Hairan ki baat hai. They are written in Bhagavatam. That Suto Anupatito Dhyato Adrito Bhanumaditaha Saddho Punati Saddharamo Deva Vishodruho Opihi. Bhagavatam 11th canto, 3rd chapter, 12th slok. It is open declaration there, but I am not getting any result. But I am speaking, I am Vaishnava, I am following Bhagavad Dharma. Foolish! You are following Bhagavad Dharma. Then why you are not getting result? Why you are not getting result? If you are at all following, something, mistake should be there, must be there. You try to detect. When you find you are not getting an inspiration, Shiva, Harinam, then try to detect. Some mistake must be there. You will have to understand if some aparat might have done or what happened, then you try to rectify, then again you can get power. Again. So whereas it is written in Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavatam Apuran, 11th canto, Sruto Anupatito Dhyato Adrito Ba Anumaditaha Shattaho Punati Shaddharamo Devo Vishodruho Opihi. Vishodro opihi, devo vishodro. If I am going against all demigods, if I am going against the whole world, still, if I am going to follow Bhagavad Dharma properly, Exactly, if I understand what is Bhagavad Dharma, or at all, if I am going to shuto, somehow I heard something about Bhagavad Dharma. Anupatito, after hearing, I under his guidance wanted to speak something, anupatito, or read something about Bhagavad Dharma. Dhyato, are Bhagavad Dharma is so great, only meditation I'm thinking. Oh, really? Bhagavad Dharma, Atma Dharma, Vaishnava, so great. Dhyato, Adrito, I'm, you know, Adrito, very good. Very good, Adrito. Oh, very good. You know, and if some pure devotee going to speak Harikatha, yes, 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 there should be Harikatha. You can call that Maharaj. You know, you can speak pure. Oh, Maharaj, what is the painful situation? Stop Harikatha. We cannot allow that Maharaj to speak Harikatha. What is the problem? His character, loose character, or has done something mistake, or cheated, has done something cheating with Guru Vaishnava, or taken money away from you. What kind of fault you have? They cannot point out. Only he said, no, we cannot allow him to speak Harikatha. Whereas all people ready to hear Harikatha, that sadhu going there, but they have taken decision not to allow. Why? Why? They can prove I am against Guru Pad Padma and Prabhupada. Eh? They have their, you know, their father can come, previous father, family father. They can come all in together to prove that I am against Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Then why they are going to stop Harikatha? Why? Everywhere. Almost everywhere. Stop. Because if I speak, it's a great problem for. So this is Bhagavad Dharma. This is Vaishnava Dharma, you see? This is a situation, painful situation. Where it is, if you can approve, yes, we should arrange Harikatha here of that Maharaj. Come. This much we cannot do. This much we cannot do. We are Acharya. We are great Vaishnava. Eh? This much we cannot do. Are he is not going to take any money, nothing, no facility, nothing. Like beggar, he can stay with on two breads and speak all about that absolute. Still, we like to kick him out of mat. This is our bhajan. We have no right to identify that I am the disciple of Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami. I have no right. We have no right to identify that I am the disciple of, you know, Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. I have no right to identify myself and the disciple of Madhu Goswami Maharaj. I have no right to identify myself and Kesava Goswami Maharaj, disciple. No right. I am a cheetah number one. So long I am going to contaminate the environment of Gaudiya society, we cannot expect any change in our life. All total evolution we need. We need total evolution. But we are busy with politics. We are busy with dirty politics all the time. Maharaj, three devotees there, only three devotees in a small mart. Only three devotees. They are also one devotee gone Maharaj politics. Politics is there inside their blood. Politics is there inside their blood, inside their blood. So they cannot avoid politics. They can never do Hari Bhajan. Never, never. In whatever position they are, they cannot do Hari Bhajan. Hari Bhajan is not so easy. Hari Bhajan is not so easy. I can give one mala to you. Oh, go and practice. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. You know, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. It's so easy, you know. Hari Hari, Haro Haro, it is written. You know, Hare Krishna speaking with cheating mood. How to cheat, where to cheat, where to go, there is the mood. This is Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. So cheap, you know, this is the situation. So whereas it is written, we have no belief in Bhagavad Dharma. Maharaj, if you are getting the smell of Bhagavad Dharma, if you are getting the smell of Bhagavad Dharma, I can put 100% guarantee. 100% guarantee. If you can give guarantee, 100%. One devotee, long ago, maybe 16 or 18 years back, I usually am doing Govardhan Parikrama without speaking anything. If some devotee at all Harikatha sometime, all the time alone doing Harinam. When I am going to do Radhakund Parikrama final, then I was bound to pay Dandavat to Tamaltala, where Mahaprabhu was sitting at the bank of, you know, Samkunda. One devotee, where he is at present, I don't know. He is from Sylhet, at present Bangladesh. He used to love me very much. I don't know why. He told Maharaj, when he heard Harikatha in Vinod Bani first time, then I could feel something. And one devotee, he just catch me inside Jagannath temple. When I was watching Jagannath, he catch me. He is waiting when Maharaj come back. When catch me and crying very heavily, he speaking, Maharaj, I don't know why. I am so fallen so, he is speaking, Maharaj. In front of Jagannath Baladev, I discover you. For a long time I was searching you. Over internet I am hearing Harikatha. And after hearing Harikatha, still I am thinking something is there. I was about to lose my patience. But that time, now, when I heard, there is a situation. That devotee crying in front of me, I am not speaking anything, I am silent, alone, but he is crying, he is speaking, Maharaj, he is speaking, I am in Vyasasana speaking this way. Maharaj, you can, my Gurudev going to cheat me this way. I say, you took shelter from him, what to do, I have nothing to speak. I am speaking, Maharaj, you can save me 100%, he is speaking. He is touching Tamaltala, you know, Tamal Bhiksha. Maharaj, I was sitting there. Then what to speak? He is crying, I was bound to speak that way. Without speaking, I cannot stay, Harikatha. Then I was also bound to speak that way. If you are speaking 100%, if you have 100% faith and belief, that I can save you, then be sure that you are already saved. Then be sure that you are already saved. Because my Guru Maharaj is not cheater. Because my Prabhupada is not cheater. Because my Kesava Goswami Maharaj is not cheater. My Sridhar Goswami Maharaj is not cheater. They are all my Guru. Prabhupada is not cheater. I was bound to speak that way. That man bursted into tears. But now I cannot find any trace. All moth gone, some other party take control, everything mismanagement, all gone. Where the devotee gone, I don't know. Now, so you should grow your faith. You should grow your faith in Bhagavad Dharma. You should grow your faith day by day in Bhagavad Dharma. By the mercy of Gauranga Mahaprabhu Nityananda Guru Bhargava, they should believe 100%. Those Mayavadi, they can recite Bhagavatam very nicely. You can dance and sing. But there is no devotional point. They can explain so nicely, so sweetly, that whole world can dance. But they don't know, there is nothing. There is no touch of any devotion. They are Mayavadi. There is no question of any devotion in his speech. But the speech is very sweet, lucrative, very catchy. Sruto anupatito dhyato adrito va anumaditaha saddho punati saddharmo devo vishya druho opihi. I promise you, you believe. Bhagavad Dharma can save you anyhow. Bhagavad Dharma can save you anyhow, any moment. Dhavan nimilito vanetre, nas karet napatet iha. No question of falling down. There should be genuinity inside your heart. There should not be any duplicity. There should not be a smell of self-interest. This much. You need not follow deho dharma, body-related dharma. You can violate the social dharma. You can violate everything. I promise you, still, no punishment you can get. What to speak about punishment? You throw all body related dharma, mental dharma, social dharma, all you can throw. You can throw away everything. You come in front of Bhagavad Dharma. You can come in front of a Mahabhagavat Guru Vaishnava. Those who are not going to cheat you, they can take you in lap. They can cross this material ocean, which is very fearful. You should believe this point. Otherwise, you cannot get inspiration to do Hari Bhajan. Hari Bhajan is not a matter of joke. Each and every fraction of second, Mayadevi try to displace you. Mayadevi try to displace you. Kalaha kalirvarina indiya vairi varga bhaktikat bhaktipat iho kantak koti ruddhya. Kalaha kalirvarina indiya vairi varga bhaktipat iho kantak koti ruddhya. Ha ha ka jami kim aham karomi chaitanya chanda yaddi naddam kipam karoshi. If somehow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his followers, those who are, Paramahansa, they are not going to bless us, save us, where to go, how to go. Because anyhow, any amount of money power, any amount of educational power, any amount of, manpower cannot save us from the imminent danger. Any amount of money power, any amount of, manpower, any amount of, educational power cannot save me from the imminent danger. Each and every second, you'll have to take protection. What is that protection? Protection of Siddhanta Vichar, protection of Harikatha Kirtan, protection of your daily life, devotional life. Each and every fact, you cannot make any mistake. If you make any mistake, you are going to get punishment. Because Mayadevi always searching one leakage. It is the duty of Mayadevi to find one leakage. I like to give you one reminder from Bhagavatam. You can remember when Diti and Aditi. Aditi, Diti, Diti Ma is the mother of all demigods. Aditi is a daitya, demons. Aditi was disappointed because all, demons, his sons, they are here and there, no place. Then Aditi wanted to satisfy Kashyap, husband, to get one blessing. And that Kashyap Muni giving him advice, you will have to follow this vrata long time. And after that, Diti giving some restriction, you cannot do it, you can do it, you should do it, you should not do it, you should do it, you should not do it, you should do it, you should not do it. All list given by whom? By Kashyap Muni. And our devotional line, what to do, what not to do, what to do, what not to do, all restriction, everything is pivoted on one single point. What is that? Pure devotional factor. If we like to satisfy Krishna, if we can satisfy Krishna, externally it is not appropriate way, illegal way, still it is good. Legality, illegality, everything, what is the standard? We have to think about the, Krishna. If Krishna is satisfied, then it's okay. Many times I discussed before. So you see, Aditi wanted to play a trick by the mercy of husband. Okay, well, I can follow this brata. After brata, I am going to get this kind of power, children, by the mercy of husband. Then I can, throw all demigods from heaven. Yes. Oh my God. He wanted to take revenge against Indra, Varun, all, demigods. Then Kashyap Rishi, what to do? He is serving, Kashyap Rishi for a long time. Kashyap Rishi, I can bless you. This kind of blessing I need. Okay. After that, Indra was very disappointed. Indra was thinking what to do. All the restrictions, spoken by, Kashyap Muni. mother Aditi is supposed to follow, but one day making mistake. Indra coming in front of mother, mother, you are taking so much trouble, nobody there with you, I can help you. I can help you, flower and fruits, I can collect from, you know, forest, everything, and I can collect wood and piece, dry. I can help you, mother, please don't say no. I love you very much, mother, I like to serve. Okay, if you like to do, you need not go, you actually doing vrata, you are so weak, so I can do. Indra was, you know, given permission. Then Indra is so clever, searching the opportunity. Then though waiting, because Aditi following all rules and regulation, you know. Then one day, Aditi forget. She was doing vrata, so strict austerity and penances. She was feeling tired, so is, you know, all long hair, head here was open, and he is not doing any achaman, anything. He was feeling tired. She, you know, started taking rest. She already sleep. Indra thought, this is the opportunity. So long I am searching, leakage. Today I get leakage. Because if there is no leakage, why those ghosts cannot attack? Why those you know, demons, they are playing, you know, black magic against pure Guru Vishnu? But they cannot do any harm. I know who is doing what. Here, there, Midnapur, here, I know who is doing what. But I say, we are going to depend upon Nityananda, Nisingadeva, Prabhupada, Guru Maharaj, give me this mantra. Baba, you must speak, Jai Gurudev, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Nisingadev. This mantra can save you 100%. I believe this promise given by Guru Maharaj. I know he is doing what. So much, you know. But let them do their own duty and go to hell. I can do my one duty. So they are always searching one leakage. How ghost can overpower you if there is leakage? If you don't do achaman, if you are not going to wash your leg after passing urine, oh, so different. Yeah, you know, so different rules and regulation. If one time you allow contamination, whole room, your deity room and whole room can be get contaminated. I cannot, you know, come into compromise with you regarding this. Maharaj, allow it. No! I cannot allow contamination. You can come from saloon and enter into room. I can throw you outside room. Go outside, foolish number one. Try to take bath, total with your clothes and everything. After that you can enter. No restriction. They are all following Shudra. They are following rules and regulations like Shudra. The, how they can expect enough power to come in their life? They are following rules and regulations like Shudra. Eh? So how you can expect they can get power? Not so easy. Every fraction of second, where to sit, when not to sit, where to go, where not to go, what to eat, where not to eat, all calculation, it is automatic. It is not politics. Automatically, if you are attached with Nityananda, automatically Nityananda can give inspiration. Don't take prasadam here. It is not at all prasadam. You know, no. You know, this bandara, don't take prasadam here. You can lose your bhajan. Really so. But if I speak in public, they can come and fight with me. Maharaj is making so much disturbance. Are Maharaj, it is not disturbance. So many devotees from this society, that they are coming. When I was in Mart in Vrindavan, some devotees, they are hearing Harikatha. That's why they're firing Harikatha. Night time. I paid Randabhadan to a lotus feet. I mean, no. Param Pujivat, this Maharaj, I don't like to speak, I love him very much. Samadhi, and you know, like intoxication, I'm coming in Vyasasana. And with closing eyes and go on speaking about everything. How I'm speaking, I don't know. One day those some of the devotees coming, Maharaj, our Martin Church speaking that you go and you know guest house, you clean all room and everything, you know, this you know their mastery, you know, mattress, you know, everything you can clean. I say, and they are saying it is Guru Seva. I say, my son, I cannot fight with anybody, but this is not Guru Seva. Many people coming in guest house. It was not the mood of Prabhupada to run mutt that way. With what contamination people coming in, what you know mentality were there? One brahmachari should not go into guest house to clean that room. You should pay some amount to a man, outside man who can manage. If he is going to touch that bed, everything you have to take. But again, he is coming and entering into kitchen to cook. Even Shudra people, they are not going to follow that way. That is a present situation. Whom to speak? I say, my son, it is not Guru Seva. But I cannot fight with them. They are speaking, it is Guru Seva. Okay, you do. I have nothing to speak. I am going to take leave from here. This way all contaminated. How we can expect? You know, acharan is a must. You know, so acharan is a must. Without acharan, no problem. So Aditi Mata today making one mistake. So long she was following Sarvul Sanyu, but one mistake done today, without washing mouth, without you know achaman and everything, and noon evening time, it is strictly prohibited to sleep with all his you know head you know ear head hairs open all. Not tightly bonded. And this is the opportunity. Indra Maharaj was bound to take this opportunity and enter in fine form into the womb of mother and going to cut the womb into, you know, 7 pieces first. 9 pieces. Again into 9, one piece, again into 9. This way, you know. And after that, Indra Maharaj go out. And on time, Aditi Ma going to give birth to Unapanchas Vayu. Eh? And asking to Indra, my son, don't speak lie. Try to speak. Why I am going to give, I wanted to give one bird. And those, you know, boys, you know, they promise inside home that we are in favor of demigods. Why you are going to kill us? Then, Unapanchas Vayu. Vayu. You know, they are there. After that, Indra bound his mother, you took decision to do your brotho that way. So, excuse me, I was bound to enter into womb because I got opportunity, golden opportunity. And after that, the program of Aditi was failure. This way all the time, Maya Devi waiting to search one leakage in your life. Now you can understand what kind of accuracy you want to meet. Maybe some of you can think I am mad. Even in dream, you cannot expect that kind of accuracy. Even in dream, what to speak about practical life. But you will have to follow. You will have to follow. So, rules and regulations. I never used to allow any devotee to enter into kitchen. But the great evolution was there against me in mat. No, nobody can enter into kitchen. What I am cooking, what is, you know, today, bhoga, I cannot so. They go against me. You know, I was very strict about those matajis and their activities. They are giving slogan against me. He speaking all rubbish against me. He's speaking. He is so strict. I think he has no mother in his life. This way, all rubbish he is speaking. They are all gone. Their future life was finished. Speaking this way. Simply because I wanted to put some restriction. as per the instruction of Prabhupada, nothing else. I never hate Matajis. I love them. They are all my mother. But I cannot allow their fanciful attitude. You know, because as per that, you know, teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you have to follow strict rules and regulations. Kitchen is not a, you know, matter of joke. Where you are going to cook something for Supreme Lord, even smell cannot come, should not come, but still what to do? We cannot follow these rules followed by Jagannath in Upanda. We'll have to food. Those who are going to cook, noontime, it was my rules, they cannot take anything in the morning time. Fasting, they will have to go fast and cook. Who is going to follow me? And who is going to get Krishna? They cannot follow me, they cannot get Krishna. So it's okay. Nobody can follow. Okay, nobody can follow. Nobody can get Krishna. But to get Krishna, you will have to follow. To get Krishna, I cannot allow all useless people to come and make disturbance. But useful people, when they know have some possibility, some potential bhakti, if I see, then I can allow you. Surely. You know, this way, you see, if there is no potency, how you can expect that, you know, Kongso can do bhakti? How you can expect that Mayavadis can do bhakti? If whatever inhuman, you know, they can take, it is there. This way, you know, I was all along in strict. I will have to follow these rules and regulations. And I will have to give instruction to you all to follow all rules and regulations. Whenever you come out from outside, you know, you have to change your clothes, take bath, change your... You cannot follow. Now what I can do? One day, one so-called devotee coming from some place and speaking in front of Prabhupada. Prabhupada, one Mayavadi guru, he is asking to a young man who just coming. He is paying pranam and Mayavadi guru speaking. Baba, my son, you are married? Yes, I am married. Oh, you are married? Oh my God, it's... Okay, you have any baby? Yes, I have any baby. Oh, ho, 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 what problem? I mean, if they are going to marry, if they have any baby, they cannot do bhajan. That is their bhajan. Idiot number one. One day, one so-called Mayavadi speaking in front of Prabhupada. You try to understand, all I am speaking about the Siddhanta Vichara Prabhupada. To project this issue, the unique acharyas of Srila Prabhupada. All Prabhupada. I have nothing. I am speaking. You know, one so-called, you know, people, they are coming in front of Prabhupada and speaking, I am Brahmachari, I am not married, Prabhupada speaking. If you are not married, you can become a Brahmachari, then those animals staying in zoo, they are 100% Brahmachari, why not? If you are not going to marry, if this be the standard, and if this is the just yardstick that you can proclaim, you can demand that you are Brahmachari, then why not? You see all the animals there, tiger, you know, bear, they are all big, big Brahmachari in the zoo, but they are not going to see the face of any female. Yeah. Tiger is not going to meet with female tiger, bear, not going to meet with, so they are great Brahmachari. You know, one day, you know, some, you know, those material people, they're in, you know, Chuchura, in Chuchura, Parampari Kesabu Simajwad, those people coming with a, you know, fighting mood, in Sabha, in front of Kesabu Simajwad, why you are all sadhu? You are all sadhu, you are supposed to stay in forest. Why you are coming here in the city, making disturbance with us? Speaking all rubbish. Eh? You are supposed to, you are sadhu. Why not you stay in forest? Kesa Kusima says, look, yes, Sadhu Guru Vaishnava, they are supposed to stay in forest. In fact, they are staying in forest. there forest? Why you are in Chuchura city? Kesava Goswami speaks, you see, we are supposed to stay in forest. In fine form, we are staying in forest. Forest means to stay with Guru Vaishnava and their Siddhanta. But the Kesava Goswami are going to give fitting answer to that man who is coming with fighting mood. Well, I'm staying in Chuchura because the forest I am supposed to stay, there is so much, you know, ferocious animals are there. So much ferima, so many ferocious animals are there in Chuchura city. That kind of, you know, ferocious animals we cannot find in the forest where you go, want to send us. That's why you are here. The man sat up. We are supposed to stay in forest, but there we don't find that kind of, you know, so much, you know, ferocious animals as we are finding here in Chuchura city. That's why I am taking trouble to stay here. Foolish number one, idiot. A doctor? You like to send a doctor to a village? To a, you know, forest? This is the system. Prabhupada wanted to make doctors. And you want to make some hooligan. You are giving birth to all illegal children in the name of Diksha. All contamination. In the name of Diksha, you are making some all illegal sons. Sons and daughters you are making. You know. But Prabhupada speaking, that we should, you know, all members of Gauriamar, they should feel, they should get power. Without power, they should not go outside. Kesava Goswami is speaking, you know, we are now at present speaking Harikatha, staying in this Chuchura city. You, in your opinion, it is city, but it's a great forest where big, big, you know, ferocious animals are there. That's why you are. Now, this is your decision. Or if you find any Guru Vaishnava pure, you like to banish him. Hey, go out, send him. It's big problem. He is going to speak Harikatha, stay here. He is making all problem. Hey, send him. Mayavadi, Mayavadi, Mayavadi. Impersonalist. Guru Vaishnava is making problem. He is speaking Harikatha. They cannot speak sweetly. So, we are like Kamsa. You know. Who is Krishna? We should cut Krishna away. We should throw Krishna away. There should not be no Krishna. They should, no, we don't like to see Krishna. Kill Krishna. Mayavadi. Or sometime Mayavadi, you know, Ravan like to abduct Shakti. It is the main symptom of Mayavadis, impersonally. Either they like to kill the Supreme Lord or his Shakti. Shakti. They like to speak that way. You know. Kill Krishna. We don't need Krishna. If Krishna is there, he can make problem. If Guru Vaishnava is there, they can make problem. They can watch with what we are doing. Noontime, sannyasi going, where? At present, I don't find even such a powerful, you know, man, who can give punishment like? Santo Goswami Maharaj, who can give punishment like? Siddhanti Maharaj. Siddhanti Maharaj giving, you know, restriction. Hey, don't go. You have taken sannyas. Don't go into the house of that widow. There, not go. Two sannyasis, three sannyasis, not going to follow. Noontime, they are going there to get bad association. Sannyasis, they are, oh, Maharaj, they are so foolish, Mahabadi. Maharaj, they are doing so much seva. Why you are speaking this way? Are you what to speak about? Your Gurudev has given initiation, sannyas, everything. I was supposed to throw you at home and give arrange two marriage for you. You are speaking, he is doing so much seva, Maharaj. He is doing some mistake, you should excuse. No! No! This kind of excuse can take the whole Gaudiya society into hell. Noontime is going where? Which flat? What he is doing? And what is duty? Nobody going to take information. Everybody like to prove that I am very nice Vaishnava, elevated Vaishnava, not speaking anything. If not speaking anything is Vaishnava, the symptom of Laksham, then we'll have to throw Prabhupada out of the list. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Kesava Goswami Maharaj will have to throw. You will have to give your enlist your name. You will have to prove that way, Mayavati. Siddhanta Maharaj, 3-4 times giving warning, don't go there. They are not going to obey. One day Siddhanta Maharaj is going to snatch. You give me your danda and cloth to me. Oh, you do. Taking away all danda, uttariya, everything. Don't go out of mat. Who can do at present? Who can do at present? That kind of power we have? Oh, Maharaj. You should not speak anything. This way actually, they took resolution, they took, to kill Siddhanti Maharaj. They wanted to kill Siddhanti Maharaj. They took decision, we can kill somehow. Okay. But Nityananda Balaram is there to save Prabhupada. Nityananda Balaram is there. Prabhupada is there. So this way, even Mahaprabhu, when speaking, you are sadhu, I am sadhu, why you are going to cheat my, sevak, you are going to take. Then Bhattatari wanted to kill Mahaprabhu. Well, okay, you kill your idiot now. Then all their weapons and everything, cutter, going to cut their throats and legs and head, everything. Their instrument. Buddhist, they wanted to give all rubbish thing to Mahaprabhu in the name of Prasadam. And that the leader of that Buddha team, going to meet with great trouble. This way actually, we should not fear. Because Balaji Maharaj is there. Balaji Maharaj is there in different form. Balaji Maharaj is going to give protection to those pure Guru Vaishnava. If somebody is going to take decision, then he can meet with great trouble. We are not going to curse them. We want to pray for them in front of Supreme Lord, that somehow they can change their mood, but not possible. Because so much aparad they have done in their life, no question of changing their mood. Down and down they are going. So they took decision to kill Siddhanti Maharaj. That was winter time. And at night time they come with one cutter, they throw and, they wanted to cut the throat of Siddhanti Maharaj. But by chance Siddhanti Maharaj sleeping just opposite. Leg is that side. Usually Maharaj sleeping head this side, leg that. That day we don't know. It is the arrangement of Prabhupada. That day Maharaj sleeping just opposite. Keeping head that side and keeping leg that side. Blood coming out like, fountain. Pain. That criminal was, they were caught. But still, Siddhanti Maharaj never wanted to give that kind of punishment. So Guru Vaishnav never liked to give punishment to anybody. They are so merciful. Maybe they have done so many cheating, they have done so many, but still they never like to give punishment. According to their karmaphal, they are going to get result. According to their karmaphal, they can get result. Who am I to give punishment? I should not give any punishment. So impersonalism can count your life. Prabhupada laughing loudly. Prabhupada usually never laughing loudly. That day when Prabhupada hearing this incident, that one Mayavadi guru said, oh, you are married. Married means you cannot do bhajan. You are married. You aren't. Are big sadhu there in grihastha life. They are more than sannyasis. They are more and more than sannyasis. They have their controlling over their sense organ. They are going to speak that way. That Mayavadi guru speaking, oh, you are married, then great problem, Actually, that Mayavadi guru explaining, my son, if those who are grihastha, he like to explain that way, those who are staying into the room, into a room which is fully full of lacquer, black, So somehow you can touch black in your body, a white cloth. You know, I mean the Mayavadi want to speak in grihastha life, it is impossible to do bhajan. So what they are Mayavadi actually. They don't know what is devotion, what is bhakti. They don't know. They are taking fish and meat, everything. But whole world going to worship them. Whole world going to worship. They are taking all everything, all rubbish. It is not at all. They are karmi. They are karmi. Total, blind karmi. When Prabhupada hearing this thing, then Mayavar Godu Guru speaking that way, Popa started laughing heavily. Ha 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 ha. Popa thinking, nothing, no touch of bhakti is there. No touch of bhakti is there in this conception. No touch of devotion is there in this conception. Pure devotee, like Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Srinivasa Acharya, and Sivananda Sen, great devotee, who not? All we can find, their grihastha devotee is so great, we like to pay dandavat unto a later spirit of those ideal grihastha. Foolish people, they are going to pass all rubbish remark about them. I know some brahmachari, you know, in Devananda Gauri Mar, used to speak all rubbish. At all, if he is going to see one married man, he is going to speak all rubbish. Ah, you are pacha grihastha. You are rotten, even a spoiled grihastha. And after that, he took sannyas, he fell down, and staying with some lady. Leading, you know, illegal life. So don't try to criticize. Try to rectify your life. Don't try to criticize anybody. What wrong? If they are grihastha, if they have full tremendous love for Guru Vaishnava, you want to prove that you are more than that? Some devotee, so-called devotee in, you know, Gauriya Math, he wanted to fight with other devotees. Anyway, those who are married, anyway, they are not going to get that kind of power as a sannyasi can get. He is speaking this way. But whereas we can see the Siddhanta Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Jayavadana everywhere, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, those who are ideal grihastha, they are more and more powerful. They are Jagadguru. But the only thing is that they have no vanity. They are always going to speak with humble attitude. We are grihastha. We have no power, nothing. We have no bhajan. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Only this difference. They are great devotee. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, according to the degree of devotion, according to your love for Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan, Harikatha, the degree of your Vaishnavism, Vaishnavata, can be, you know, identified. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is with Vaishnavism. Vaishnavata is not such a thing. Though we can think, he is married, he is not Vaishnava, he is not married. No! But a great Acharya Prabhupada speaking. Prabhupada speaking, he is Mayavadi. He is Mayavadi. When Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you know, Siddhanta was this way, then that man on hearing the Siddhanta Bhaktivinoda, he was not at all satisfied. Oh, anyhow, those who are not married, they are, you know, those sannyasi. Yeah, who is sannyasi? Who is going to understand? Who is going to arrest whom at present? Who is going to follow sannyas vrata perfectly? Who can say? Who can say? You know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, those who are sannyas, those who are ideal grihastha, even they can act as guru of those, you know, those who are in renounced order. They can. Only the difference is that simply they are staying in grihastha dharma, that's why they cannot give sannyas to anybody. This is the rules. They can give, but still they don't, because it is, you know, people can criticize. So pure Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur can give sannyas to thousands of people. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur not giving. Why? Because Bhaktivinoda Thakur like to show that, okay, when, you know, When some ideal devotee, ideal grihastha is staying in grihastha ashram, you know, I can give you, show you comparison, what a sannyas doing whole day and night. And they are grihastha, what they are doing. Their life is dedicated whole day and night, doing preaching service, this, that. They are crying, we have no bhakti. So I cannot love them? Why? I can throw them? How I can throw them? How I can throw them? Whereas I see they are doing everything, you know, they have no, you know. What they have done previously, that is okay. But at present, they are coming in front of me, they are staying with me. All the time went to hear Aikatha. How we can throw them? Sannyas, if he cannot maintain any standard, who is going to give punishment? What is the duty of Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava? Yesterday I was speaking, na? That Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur himself is Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava. He himself is Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava. Inside the heart of Prabhupada, all Guru Varga. And their assembly we can find. So Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur alone is total, complete Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava. But who is going to obey? I am trying my best. I would request you all to follow, to get result in bhajan. And if somebody going against me to fight, to give me punishment for that, okay, they can go. I have no anxiety, no tension, because I have no bodyguard, I have no manpower, nothing I have. I have only Gurudev and Guru Varga. Anything they like to do, they can do, they can try to do, they can see what is the result. You know, I have no hostility against anybody, Popa speaking, under the guidance of Popa, I am also bound to speak. I have no competition with any Acharya, nobody. I promise, I have no competition with anybody. I have no hostility with anybody, I can promise. I have no hostility. I am not going to take any revenge against anybody. But I am bound to speak that way, bound to speak that way, bound to speak that way. Only because I love you all. Nothing else. Don't think it negative way. Don't try to feel a reaction to take revenge against me. Of course, if you are going to take revenge, you can do. You can try. All the time we have to discuss about Prabhupada, all the time we will have to discuss about Guru Varga, Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, to give us full protection. Kesava Goswami is speaking, if we are going to cultivate some sabji or flower, Kesava Goswami is speaking, suppose we are going to cultivate some flower and fruits in a field, if we are not going to arrange total, you know, protection, barrier, then goat and cow or ox can come and eat up. Kesava Goswami speaking. We should give full protection. That full protection is Siddhanta Vichar, Satusanga, strict rules and regulation, this call. All the time we'll have to follow. This is called your protection. All the time, not that fraction of second, you can do some asasanga, mentally, even mentally, prohibited. So this is your protection. You'll have to take the protection of Siddhanta Vichar. You'll have to take the protection of Harikatha, Hari Bhajan, protection of rules and etiquette, everything. All rules and regulations, strict, you know, achar, acharan. Nobody can throw you from bhajan. Mayadevi cannot get scope to find one leakage in your bhajan life. Try to protect yourself, then you can. If you are genuine, if genuine prayer is the answer, then you can enjoy it. Divine help can automatically come in your life. You can automatically get divine help. Only that thing you should have genuinity. You must have genuinity. Automatically you can get divine help from, you know, He is going to protect us. Full protection, Nityananda Guru Varga can give. So, I wanted to discuss so many things, but time cannot permit. Next day, I can clarify all this point. That how we can understand who is bhakti, what is bhakti, who is devotee, who is not, what is the duplicity there. How to develop, you know, accuracy, sensitivity in your bhajan. So, I can explain this sloka next day. Yasyasti bhaktir bhagavati akinchana sarva gunis tatro shama sati suraha haru abhakta sakuta mahat gunaha mano rathena sato dhavato bahi. I can explain this sloka, I cannot forget. I can remember. Surely, I cannot forget. I can remember, I can discuss this under the guidance of Prabhupada. Gaurangaika gatir bhajasyatamati si gaurdhama sthiti sasasaika vitir kusanga virati dusto vetha niskriti si rupai karati sanatana nati si jivate jasuti si siddhanta saraswati vijayate gauriya goshtipati si siddhanta saraswati vijayate Gauri Agosti Pati Vanchakalpatrosi Kipasindhu Bhavcha Patitanang Pavanam Bhavishnabhyo Namo.